cash withdrawals. It's renovating money.
Just want to make sure you're all right, sir. Anyway, happy renovating.
Me old man, we saw this big fucking crash. Big semi just went right over the top of a little Jap jump. There's a girl stuck in the car. I would have been about 15, I guess. Car's so deep, the yumbos are on the way, and my dad, he can't get in there. So I say, hey, Dad, I can fit, I can get in there. There's this little gap, right? So I get in. Fuck me dead, the girl's alive. I can just see her head and body's trapped in the car. She'd be about 25. It's long, curly blonde hair. Pretty. She's got blood on her forehead, but she smiles. You know, this big, beautiful smile. I say, you okay? You okay? She's like, yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine. So I keep it talking about a dog and stuff, you know, until finally we hear the sirens and it's time for me to get out. And she says to me, she says, well, Ronnie, my name's Sarah. When I get out of here, I'm going to give you the best night you've ever had. Which to me, right, I'm like 15, so that's big news. So I get out feeling pretty good, right? And finally the fire is... They have the jaws for life, and they open the doors. And the body's not connected to her head. Decapitated, right? After that, no one looks at me in the eye. My old man, he just pretends like it never happened, you know, like I'm crazy or something. Mind you, her name was really Sarah. Isn't that spooky? Anyway, Andy, I'm telling you this story because everything I ever had has never been quite real. It's just disappeared, you know, like steam off a grate. Except for Dale. You see, she's real. The cops might have picked you up.
Just took longer than I thought.
Now be careful with this, okay? It's loaded.
You wouldn't want to lose me at this point.
So you're just gonna leave him here? What are you doing, Ron?
Listen, Dale, it's not a bad way to go. And pass me the tape, will you?
Ron, you promised.
I know, but that was more of a little white lie. You know that he had his old man bumped, huh? He's not such a babe in the wood, Dale. Yeah, Gary was rooting his old man, so he had him knocked off. How sick is that?
Now the tape! The tape, Dale!
No!
Don't make me stand here!
Let him go, Ron!
Dale, we had no choice. We have no choice. We never did.
I don't want you to kill him.
You better make a fucking choice right now because there's gonna be one dead prick in this room.
Which is it,
Dale? Him or me, Dale?
Stop it, Ron!
Him or me! Him or me, Dale!
Thank you.
Think of this as Dr. Ron's instant 5-year cure. Now, she's been in there about 5 minutes. You get out there and you turn that engine off, well, we'll just call it a harsh lesson, won't we? But if not, well, you'll have to live with that, won't you? The man who couldn't walk across his own backyard to save his girl. Go on, Andy. Come on, buddy. Come on, you pathetic prick. Get up there, Andy. Go on. Come on, Andy. Go on. That's it. Go on. That's it, Andy. Come on. That's it. That's it. You're nearly there, Andy. Oh, come on, Andy. Get up. Don't you quit on me, Andy. Come on. There we go. Oops. Did I lock it?
Damn.
I'd make a bloody good shrink, don't you reckon, Ann?
Damn.
At least you tried.
Damn.
Hey. Hey. She's got, buddy. 3 minutes or less. She's dying, Andy. You can run like a bloody rabbit, Andy. Dr. Ron was spot on, don't you reckon? That's because we're the same, Andy. Except, I'm always one step ahead. Very good, Andy, very good. Come on, Andy, come on. Is that all you got, Andy? You can do better. Put you back in there, Andy.
Do it. We're just the same, Andrew.
Come on. Daryl!